So welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to have a look at creating software RAID volumes within SUSE Linux. So I've opened up a supervisory root prompt and I'm going to start off by creating partitions on my disk. So I've already got plenty of partitions on my play machine, so I'm just creating some extra logical partitions. I'm setting a 500 meg partition. I'm setting the partition type for the new partition 12 to be FD, Foxtrot Delta, which is for a RAID partition. Create another partition, also a 500 meg. Now I know there's no point setting both partitions for the same disk, but this is just a demonstration after all. So again, I'm setting the type for partition 13 to be FD again. I save my partition table, so write to save, or W. And then, of course, I need to sync both my disk partition table with my memory resident partition table. And we use part probe for that. So part probe /dev SDA, as you can see. So this is then just syncing my disk partition that I've just written to my memory resident partition table. So they become available to me as partitions in my current session. To manage our RAID of arrays, we use MDADM, so --create. We're creating a RAID device called MD2, created with an E. The chunk size, so --chunk, is going to be 4K, so this is really the blocks that we're mirroring. Our level sets are RAID level, so RAID level 1 is mirroring. We're going to specify that we're going to use two RAID devices, which of course are necessary for mirroring. And then we include then device SDA 12 and 13, and they're just space separated. So we can see that it's started then device MD2. We need to make sure that these are started every time the system starts, so we have a service to manage this. I'm going to format the device now, so make it available as a file system. So I'm just going to use ext3. And of course it's MD2 that we're formatting. So Control L clears the screen. We're going to take a look in our initd directory and then look at the script that is used, or start the script. So this needs to start each time the system starts. So I can start it now, but all that's doing is starting all of my RAID devices. So we use check config -a to add it in, boot.md. So it's going to start every time. Now it's shown as a boot run level, which technically is not a run level, but it's a dependency run level for everything else. We need the configuration details of our devices. So we can get that from mdadmin --detail --scan. If we send, so we're going to append the output through to etc/mdadm.conf, so we're appending to the file. Now I already had some RAID devices in there, so when I go through and edit that, some of my information is duplicated, so I just take out the MD0 and the MD1, so it just leaves me now with 0, 1 and 2 rather than 0 and 1 being duplicated. So we need this configuration file, and this is, if you like, the file that is read when we start our MD or boot.md service. I'm going to check my fstab file and I'm going to put an entry to auto mount this. So I'm just copying an entry, so dev MD2 now is going to mount to my export and data 3 directory. CXT3, I can use the defaults, and I can leave the 0 and 2 for the dump fs and the file system check. I use a mount minus a, it's going to double check then. I think this is really important. I don't want spelling mistakes. And we can see that we have now mounted MD2. The worst I can do is mount it manually and then rely that I spell everything correct in my fstab file. The proof of the pudding is in the eating, is making sure that everything does work on reboot. So when we restart our system, we should still see that everything is mounted without me having to do anything. This is then double checking that we've configured the check config statement to auto start the boot.md service. So we're booting up, we're logging back in as my ordinary user. We'll jump back out into a prompt and we'll double check the mount command to see that device MD2, our RAID 1 device, is correctly mounted through to our export data 3 directory. So typing mount on its own, we can see now that MD2 is mounted. Thank you, I look forward to seeing you back soon.